It's time to get your medical questions answered live.
If you have a question for Dr. Zorba Paster, the number to call is 270-9933. Zorba joins us again from his clinic in Oregon. Phones are jammed, so let's go right to Judy in Madison. Hi, Judy. What's your question?
Hi. I make homemade masks that are sort of styled after the Olsen mask. They're made out of two layers of cloth, but I do put a piece of fusible interfacing in them. Is that... Make them a better bet.
Actually, they are making better because these are really made of multiple layers. And if you make it with multiple layers, I'm sorry, I put it up on the camera. If they're made with multiple layers, once again, the goal is to keep down the droplets, the big droplets and the small droplets. So the answer is yes. Keep doing it. It's fun. The more, I think the more fun we make masks, the more likely we are to have people wear them and the more comfortable they are. So keep up the good work. Keep handing them out to people, and I'm sure they'll love them. I love looking at different masks. They're kind of fun.
All right. Keep up the good work. Judy, let's go to Sue in Mount Horeb. Hi, Sue. What's your question?
My question is that it's difficult to find masks that work for us who wear glasses.
Right.
They fog up very easily with some of the standard kind of masks that you can find. So I'm wondering if you have a suggestion on a type of mask that goes higher on the nose so it would help prevent the fogging of glasses because the glasses could actually sit on the mask.
Sure. No, I know that's a problem. And some people then use things that are much looser like this, so they're not really quite as perfect a mask, but they don't fog up the glasses, and then you'll be able to use them. I'm not a seamstress, so I can't answer the question. I wish I could do it. I would look on Amazon, and you're not the first person to mention it. The tighter the mask, the more difficult. Now, the N95s that go like this, that are totally sealed, are actually less likely to fog up the eyes than anything else. They're fogging up eyes because basically air is going up from the mask. So either really, really loose so it gets out to the sideways, or really, really tight so it doesn't go up, and use an N95.
Okay.
I had that problem too, and I found if you put tissue on the top of the mask, that stops it.
Sounds like
a great idea. That's a great tip.
We got to do a blog and a website. I'm sure that there are websites out there with masks. Right.
All right. Let's go to Bobby Sue in Fort Atkinson. Hi there. What's your question?
I have a question about allergies. I am allergic to latex, rubber, and most elastic. So I am currently using the neck gaiter, and it seems to be working. But I'm wondering because at my employer, they're actually recommending the first two that you put on there. Do you have any other recommendations besides?
Well, these masks have no latex in them. I mean, these are latex free. And you can buy these online. I just looked today on Amazon, and I think they're 10 for $5 or $6 now. They're not as expensive as they used to be. So this is a latex-free mask. And once again, you've got to do what your employer asks you to do. And for instance, in our office, we either have to wear this or an N95, because that's what we do in our office. So I think I'd go to something like this instead of a cloth.
The blue ones are made out of paper, right?
Mm-hmm. They're made out of some kind of a paper product, right? They're manufactured paper.
And Zorba, is it blue?
They might have cotton in them. I really don't know what's in them, but they don't have elastic.
Is it blue side out or white side out?
It's blue side out, baby blue. Who wouldn't want to have white side out? The reality is you can do it either way, but look at it. It's not as fashionable as blue side. I'm sure it doesn't make any difference, but it is blue side out.
Okay, good to know.
Well, all you have to do is go to any one of the TV shows where they show doctors in the surgery room. They're always wearing blue.
Of course.
Right?
Play one on TV. All right, let's go to Sharon in Monona. Hi, Sharon.
Hi.
Hi, which question?
My question is, since the coronavirus affects majorly the heart, the lungs, and then it also can affect the heart, why is cigarette smoking not considered a risk factor?
Oh, I think cigarette smoking is definitely a risk factor. There's no doubt about it. It may not be the major risk factor. Cigarette smoking is always a risk factor for any disease that you get of the lungs, period. So they may not list it as one of the major risk factors, but it is. And so we should probably list it in there. No doubt about it. Smoking is never good for you. Smoking is always bad for you. That's the maxim.
All right, we are out of time. Thank you, everyone, for calling in. Remember, 8 o'clock Monday morning, Dane County, mask up.
That's right. Thank you for your calls, everybody. And Zorba, thank you for your time. We'll do this again soon.
Bye, guys. We go.
All right, well, if I-